How was it to be a child prodigy?
I was old. I was never a child. I'm much more childish now than I was then. We were very, very close, very close-knit family. We were living in Helm, close to the Russian border. My mother, father, and my sister Alice. I never went to normal schools because I was playing the violin, but I was educated by private tutors, which my father hired to educate me. And I had, of course, my violin teacher, but that came much later. That came when I went to Warsaw. Her name is Esther Greenbaum. She's still alive in Los Angeles.
Ida came to me when she was five. And I remember I was teaching her a few years, and she was the greatest talent in Poland. And she was so fast, but I thought she not only understood and remembered, but she was a genius. She put the finger that, like, you couldn't pick up the finger from the violin. She was strong, and she was born, her head was wonderful. This is what special, this little ticker. And it was like she was born to play violin. I know her father, and they were poor at this time. And the father helped him a lot. He was a shrewd man. He came to the papers, and he talked about the daughter, and she was playing. You know, the father was, he didn't let her, but I don't know, you should tell her. She couldn't go out with the boy, you know, he held her that way. She belonged only to him. And because of this, she didn't have the use what other children have, you know.
Shut those babies up, I have to work.
I didn't say
you
that.
Know,
I did not never ever say that.
Yeah, you did.
I expected her, if the kids got up in the middle of the night, I'd expect her to go take care of it.
So why would you go and help?
Because I'd have to get up in the morning.
Hold on a second. So other than the fact that there wasn't enough passion in the marriage for you, that's why you're leaving this marriage?
No, it's not about just passion, Your Honor. It's about being seen and being loved and being made to feel like you're still a woman. I didn't even
know you had affairs and that made you feel like a woman?
I didn't have affairs till I felt like nothing.
So what was the time when I made you feel like nothing? Just because he didn't take you on dates?
When people apply that terminology, unconditional love, my parents, yeah. I was very respectful. I adored them. I was affectionate, kissed them day and night, and they kissed me back. I was rather obedient because I liked it. It's not that they pressured me to do it, but I felt safe and secure in their love, and I basked in it.
I fell to play the violin. My father, as a very fanatic religious man, he didn't want me to play the violin. He considered a violinist the lowest human being. But I still was thinking about music, and I had it in my blood. And I said, when I will marry and I will have a child, I will try to give them this what I supposed to be. So one day, after my painting, I went out for a walk, and for an hour or some. When I came back, my little daughter said to me, Daddy, I want to play for you something. So she picked up my older daughter's violin and she started to play.
I have to go out the back and play.
Oh, you still play?
Yes, yes. That's my sister, Walter.
We met.
Yeah, we met.
You're always nervous?
Yes. I have to take a pill when she plays. Because I'm all shaking. More than the moment I do some playing. You know? It's funny. I'm nervous, yes, very nervous. Sometimes I wish I wouldn't go. Because I'm...
Nervous for what?
When she plays, I don't know. Nervous in case something happens.
I never went through a normal childhood because, as you know, I was on the stage from day one, and I don't know what it's like to go to school, like a normal child, to associate with other children. Because I always felt that I'm a violinist, as I said so many times. When I saw other children playing with dolls, I said, what is that? Why are they wasting their time and playing with a doll when I have a violin?
Would you have liked to go to school?
No, no, I was terribly happy. I was very, very happy. Loved my family. All I needed was my family, our parents, and my sister. You know, as a child, she was beautiful. She still is. Because look at the bone structure.
Oh, okay.
Look how lovely she is. No, I'm being very, Alice,
don't
interfere. Be silent.
I don't like it.
Why?
I don't like your compliments. Thank you.
This is not a compliment.
Well,
it's a statement of fact.
Okay.
So, but I was always proud, and I always exploited that in her. And I said, okay, we have different gifts. I'm gifted to play the violin. She has a different gift. So the competition from that area never occurred.